Hey, what's up guys, Jeremy here. In this video, we will learn how to manage inputs and outputs with RoboDK. Let's get started. Inputs and outputs are very important in most robotic stations. You might want to raise an output to open or close a gripper. You might want to wait for an input before doing a given task, and many other examples like that. So let's see how RoboDK handles this. So for this example, we will take 7G input and outputs. So I have it here. Perfect. So this one is a very simple, let's say we just have an ABB robot. I don't want to go too complicated with so too many fancy stuff around. The goal here is just to show you how inputs and outputs works. So first of all, you need to create yourself a project. So let's call this one test input. And that's it. So here you can see we have an option called set a specific output or waits for a specific input to attain a given value. So we can do that here. It will automatically bring us a set IO5 equal 1. So if we right click and we say modify, you will see this little window appearing. So you have the choice between set digital output, set analog output, or wait for digital input. So let's start with the first one. So depending on your robot brand, and this will require you to have a certain knowledge regarding how your robot brand works. You might want to have to use here either a number or a name. So in most cases, it will be a number. So you can just like leave it as is and enter whatever input or output values or number you want to use. And then you can use either for the value, either 0 or 1 or true or false, depending on how your robot brand works. Generally, the post-processor will do the translation between 0 and false and 1 and true automatically. So you don't really need to bother with that. We'll talk about post-processor in a future module where we will go more in depth about these kind of details. But for now, we will just leave it at 1. So if I click IO name 5, IO value 1, and then I run this program here, in the user interface here, nothing happens. But if you were to right click here and select station parameters, we never went there so far, but this is a way to have some information about your station. And here you have IO 5 equal 1. So this is where you'll be able to follow which IOs are at what state. So if I was to right click, add instruction, set IO or wait here, and then maybe modify, and then I can call it, I don't know, conveyor here, and have it at false, click OK, and then run this here, right click, station parameters, and now we have IO5 at 1 and we have conveyor at false. So you'll have kind of the list of all the station parameters you created, including all the IOs. So that's the first thing. Then you can add a wait if you want. So you can wait, you can wait for a specific digital input to be at a given state. So you can say here, wait IO5 at 1, let's say, or wait IO5 at 0. Let's say I'm gonna give you a small example. And then you can add a timeout of a certain time if you don't wanna wait forever for that IO. So if I do that here and I click test, here you will see that we now, the param pointer or the little orange arrow is now waiting for IO5 to become 0. IO5 is obviously right now 1 because we just set it at 1 earlier. You can right click here and click skip DI wait. So that will simply kind of follow and continue with your program. Or you can decide to have another program here. We'll call it, let's call it IO5 false, and I will add a set IO, modify at false, and if I run this one here, and if I run this one here, automatically this one goes true because I'm just setting the IO, the output 5 at 0. So that's great. I can also do the same with an analog output. Within RoboDK, it won't matter much here because you can always enter whatever value you want here, like that. But it will matter when it comes the time to post-process that, because it won't be the same instruction for the robot controller if you are triggering a simple digital output or if you are triggering a an analog output. So those are two set of instructions generally. So the fact that you define it specifically within RoboDK will have an impact on how the post-processor will behave and therefore how the robot will behave. So setting up an output or a variable is as simple as that within RoboDK. So I don't have much more to say in this video, but in the next one, we will see how we can use that in a very clever way to synchronize multiple robots together. So I hope to see you there. In any case, have a great day, guys.